Good day, YouTube. This is Jay Money with Falling Forward Financial. Just an update here on Apple. I've talked about them a couple times here in the past, and just time for an update on them. There's always a lot going on with Apple. I've held it for quite some time and just let it sit here and do its thing. I was dancing around in the 180s there for a while, and I thought about selling it and rebuying it, but didn't. Here was a little dip, but made a couple extra bucks. But here's a look over the last year, up over 35.5%, so not too shabby. Up over 24% in the last 3 months. In the last month, 1.75% in the green. It's actually down in the last week, 2.81%, and down a little bit today. So this is Apple, ticker AAPL. And as you can see, I have 7 1/2 partial shares here. You can buy partial shares here on Robinhood. If you don't know what that is, if you don't have $173.15, you can put in an order for, just say you want to buy $10, $20, $50 worth of Apple. Say you don't have the full $173, you could put in $10, $20 a week and just keep doing that until you get a full share, and then you get dividends and just keep compounding that way. I think you can buy partial shares on Fidelity, possibly TD Ameritrade. I haven't tried buying on either one of those platforms, so if you have any information on that, go ahead and list it in the comments. Moving on here, and if you don't know much about Apple, feel free to pause and go over that information. You're probably watching it on this video, possibly on an Apple device. They've been around since 1976, 58.96 million shares, average of 80.95, with a $2.84 trillion market cap. I think they were close to 3. Maybe they did surpass 3 when they were at the 180s. That I don't remember, so, but I got some more information over that here and later in the video. So, and great ratings on this one at a 79% buy. So, and here's a look at their next earnings on January 27th. And as you can see, it's been a while since I've bought any Apple here, but I keep getting these dividends, so kind of nice. And so I had 7.1608, same there. So they did increase their dividend, looks like by, went from 0.205 to 22, so up 1.5, so not too bad. Could have a better dividend, but you also get the share appreciation on this one plus the dividend, so if you want more than that, you just have to buy more shares, so maybe they'll increase it down the road as well. So over here on Bing, currently showing it as a buy. Can Apple stock reclaim the $3 trillion and thrive in 2022? And as you can see, this is just 7 hours ago. So far proven to be a ceiling that Apple stock does not seem ready to break through yet. Can shares reclaim the milestone soon and head higher in the new year? In mid-December is when I first started watching it. Flirted with $3 trillion in market cap. However, the share price did not hold up above those levels for any longer. Then a few minutes more recently, Apple finally reached the milestone again, but quickly dipped below to $2.9 trillion. So, not too big of a deal. It's kind of cool to see it hit milestones like that, but $2.9 trillion, I mean, can't complain about that at all. Can shares of the Cupertino company finally find its way north in 2022 and meet the expectations of so many bulls on Wall Street? We shall soon wait and see, and that's just an amazing, cool-looking building. So, Figure 1, Apple Park in Cupertino, California. And here's the bull case. Stock climbed viciously between late November and late December. That's when it first started going off. That's what made me first start watching it. But other analysts have also hopped on a bullish bandwagon recently. Morgan Stanley upped its price target to $200 a share in November, while J.P. Morgan Research saw the Apple stock heading to $3.5 trillion in market cap over the next 12 months. So we shall see, I'm sure. Well, maybe in a month or two, maybe it'll get back up there, maybe less, who knows? Apple stock, a robust demand to drive it higher, despite the uncertain macro environment and industry-wide supply constraints, which had almost a $6 billion impact on its revenues. Apple stock outperformed the benchmark index in 2021. So just November and December alone, they had 2 great months. What's next in 2022? Remains upbeat and expects to benefit from strong demand trends for its products. There's always demands for the products. They're always working on new products, innovation and replace, and always demand. So, along with Ives, more analysts have a bullish outlook on Apple stock. It has also received a 21 buy, 3 hold, 1 sell recommendations for a strong buy analyst consensus, rating more over the average Apple price target of $175.28 is in line with the current market price. This is the article that made me do a video. I just didn't get it done yesterday. But Apple's road to a 4 trillion starts with its rumored headset and Apple Car. I've talked about the Apple Car once or twice here on the channel before, and there's been so much speculation about it, I just haven't heard much about it lately. Basically, the last part that I heard about the car, it's going to be like an Apple operating system, and somebody else would design the body, whether that be I've heard Volkswagen, Kia, what was the other one? Hyundai, I think was from my last video, just going from memory. Apple on Monday made history by becoming the first publicly traded company with a market cap of $3 trillion. It's now seesawing back and forth between the mark for the thrill of it. It's a remarkable feat for a company that needed a cash infusion from rival Microsoft in 1997 to stay afloat, but $3 trillion is Monday's news. So where does the company go from here? I feel it's probably gonna be on its way to $4 trillion. So I don't know, a year or two, maybe less. It's hard to say what products they come out with and what happens with the stock. And I got in on the last split, so I was happy for that. And I'm sure it'll be splitting again here. So, is Apple stocks overvalued or undervalued? And again, this is 5 hours ago. So, they outperformed the S&P in the past year, generating a 12-month return of 39.7%. Right there says it all. There's days I just want to get rid of all my MJ stocks, all my other stuff, and just put my money into Apple and call it a day and just be easy, but that's no fun, so I do it the other way. So, and do Apple on the side. But with a 2.9 trillion market cap, some investors are wondering if there's any value left in Apple stock. Price to earnings ratio is one of the most basic fundamental metrics for gauging a stock's value. And Apple's PE is currently 32, slightly above the S&P 500 average as a whole. And here kind of goes over some more information. Average analyst price target of 38 analysts covering Apple is 175. And we'll go over some more ratings here at the end. Visualizing Apple's $3 trillion market valuation, and again, this is kind of some of the same information from 4 hours ago. So it briefly hit 182.88 during trading on Monday, enough to secure Apple the coveted crown of becoming the first publicly traded company on the planet to cross the $3 trillion market capitalization mark. So you know what, something like that happens, it's got to come down because people are going to sell, and once it hits, but that's just me speculating. But I thought about selling it, but I'm just keeping it and letting it set and do its thing. So, hitting $3 trillion is another historical moment for Apple. To put it into perspective, Apple's value now surpasses the nominal gross domestic product of 6 of the world's top 10 economies, including United Kingdom, India, France, Italy, Canada, and South Korea. Just blows my mind how huge this company is. Just enormous. Is Apple a good FANG stock to own in 2022? I say it is, but I don't give tax, legal, or trading advice. You can see I have shares, and I have a lot more in retirement account, and just let it sit there on DRIP and do its thing. If you don't know what DRIP is, it's a dividend reinvestment program or plan, whatever the P is, but that way your dividends are applied to a partial share of Apple. Renowned tech giant made history by becoming the first company to hit $3 trillion on January 3rd of 2021. So what a milestone on the first day of trading on the new year. So can't brag too much more on that. And nothing there on Reddit. Over here on StockTwits, currently at 173.29, low of 116.21, a high of 182.13. And we'll see if there's any other information here. Let's see what Tesla's at today. The SPY's up, Q's are up. See what Amazon and Microsoft are. But I have a couple shares of Amazon. Maybe it's going to come up and maybe not. And I have a couple shares of Microsoft. Just don't talk about them a whole lot. I have Amazon a time or two, but it's currently, it was at 3,500. It might have hit 3,600 at one point in time, but it's down a little bit. It's staying kind of steady. Over here on MSN Money, currently, of course, showing Apple as a buy and showing a strong buy here on tip ranks to 175.28. But that's all that I have on Apple. If you have any Apple shares, go ahead and list that in the comments along with your cost basis. Any other information you'd like to share in regards to Apple, especially the car or any new innovative products they have coming out, so we can make note of that and watch the stock price together. And if you haven't smashed that like button yet, go ahead and hit that for me, as well as subscribing and hit the bell so you're notified of when the next videos drop. Again, this is Jay Money, Falling Forward Financial. Happy trading, happy investing, stay green. Cheers.